Erica and I are on the island of Gozo, which is one of the three islands that make up Malta. And we're in a bay called Dwoya Bay. We've been here for about a week and it is a magnificent day. There are only two other boats in the bay here with us, and the bay is almost completely enclosed except for a very small passage there, about 40 meters wide, and an even smaller one over there, so the protection is fabulous.
Look at all the motorboats behind us. When we came into this bay on Thursday, there was two yachts, us and one more. It's the weekend now, have a look.
Got a wonderful friend, Mark, from Sailing Vessel Tuscany, and this is what he says: having guests on board is like having fish on board. The first day you have fish, fabulous. You love it, you eat it, delicious. The second day, however, the fish get a little bit smelly. And by the third day, you just want to get the fish and the guests off the boat. But we don't feel like that about having guests on board.
No, we love having guests on board.
And this is why.
The whole purpose of this Sailing with Thankfulness journey is to inspire, to encourage, and to bring hope.
For those of you who've been following our journey, you know our story. But just in quick summary.
Stephen and I, over the last 5 years, have experienced tremendous transformation in our lives.
Together, we've experienced firsthand what God means when he says he heals the brokenhearted, sets the captive free, and gives us a hope and a future.
And how cool is it that we get to do this transformational journey while living out our dreams, sailing around the world?
Today, we've got a good 13 to 15 knots. The sun's out, the waves are small, and the wind's consistent, and the motor's off, which is the important thing. So, super excited for a great sailing day today in Greece.
So now we feel it's our turn to give back, to inspire, to encourage, and to bring hope, because we know that it is possible to move into and to live your best life, no matter what life has thrown at you.
One of the ways we can do this is by welcoming guests on board.
Not a bad effort for lunch today. What do you reckon?
Yay!
Guests who are looking for clarity as to their own God-given purpose.
Most of our guests are in some stage of transition, retirement, empty nesters, changing careers, needing a new path, or even guests who have had dreams and visions their entire lives, but haven't yet stepped in to see these dreams become a reality.
Living on board as guests can be like a circuit breaker from your normal life and give you the opportunity to dream again.
As we live life together aboard our boat and share experiences with our guests, we dream together of what is possible and as a team, strategize the possibilities for the next step forward.
Stephen's in his happy place.
There's been a request to learn knots. Everybody's looking forward to learning how to tie a bow line.
Not a bad environment to do it.
One couple we've had the privilege of journeying with on the boat is Kathy and Jonathan. They're the founders of Hope on the Road. Have a listen to some gems from these guys as to why they've had dreams for years, but not until now have they fully stepped into pursuing those dreams.
I've already got a name. It's called Possibilities Unlimited. Possibilities Unlimited. I've had the domain name for about 20 years. I've had another one called learnworks.com, and I've been researching learning management systems and all sorts of things of how I might be able to do online training. And
so you've had all these domain names ready for 20 years. Why has it taken so long from the dreaming to actually get to today where you're ready to implement?
Well, there's a number of things that have stopped us. One is a big lack of confidence. Maybe you've been smashed in life. We certainly were. Heard words. We felt like failures. Things happened. And that all affects confidence, your belief in yourself and your belief in what you can do for others and your belief in others. And with that, the enthusiasm goes, the energy goes, and so it just becomes a vicious circle. So it's really important to have somebody and some mechanism, some catalyst that will help you rebuild your confidence long enough to get the enthusiasm and the energy back to actually believe in yourself again, what you can do for others, and belief in other people again. Number two is a lack of clarity. And I've got lots of bits and pieces, lots of experiences, lots of ideas, but bring you all that together. And that's the catalyst of getting under a coach and becoming part of a coaching program. People who work with you side by side with other people who also go through the same stuff. And I think that's the other thing, is you realize eventually that you're not the only person going through this, and therefore you can help others through this process as well.
That's what we've come to realize. I think that's the important thing. It's not to compare ourselves with other people. It's just run our own race. And this is something we've taught forever. But then it's like all the fingers point back at you. I mean, we've been thinking about all these things for years. It's not hard questions. We've already got the answers there. They're just going to be written down, really, because we've been talking, thinking, ruminating all these years.
Focused. Guided process.
Done the race, and you've only got this much time on this planet. Do it, and do it now. So that's what we're doing.
What we really understand about these guys is that the gifts of God are irrevocable. They've had callings on their life since they were teenagers. They've stepped into the call that God has on their life. And then after they get smashed, you forget those callings. But the truth is that they're still there. The passions, the calling, the alignment, the purpose, it's still all there. Well, it's just been covered up by a whole lot of stuff, a whole lot of life that happens. And that's where we come along and come beside and cheer our beautiful, beautiful friends on. We believe so much in these guys.
But it also took a couple who are willing to be sensitive to the leading of the Spirit to pray for us, and then generous enough of nature to invite us onto their boat and to share their lives with us. And I think we've been a blessing to them as well. And that's just how synergy works.
So I want to honour them for being sensitive and willing and obedient and generous and good looking.
I'm pretty sure the good looking one referred to me.
Why is everybody coughing?
Yes, the good looking one is referring to you, beautiful. And that's the thing about team that Kathy's been talking about. You know, for Stephen and I, we've got our purpose, we've got our clarity, we've got our alignment, but we both come from second marriages. This is our second marriage. And so these guys have been married for 32 years. And they have a wealth of information and knowledge and skills on how to communicate well. And so I've brought stuff from my past marriage. Steve has brought stuff from his past marriage. And having these guys here with us and seeing how we interact or seeing how we communicate together, they've had gold that they've been able to invest in our lives as well. So that's when the synergy happens. It's not just us loving on these guys. It's these guys loving on us and helping us have even a better marriage than we've had before.
How important is team in all of this? We're all learning from each other. If God can do it in our lives,
we know he can do it in your lives as well.
It is so exciting to see.
It's kind of like we've got a front row seat in all the action of people's lives being transformed.
And this is why we love to have people on board Thankfulness.
It's our hope and desire that you found something in this video encouraging, inspiring, or uplifting.